3 years ago, the world stood on the brink of financial ruin. Too big to fail, HBO's new movie, which premieres Monday night, chronicles how it all unfolded from the bank failures to the bailouts. Christia Freeland is back with us, and we're joined by the film's writer and co-producer, Peter Gould. Let's take a look at the movie. In this scene, former Treasury Secretary Hank Paulson, played by William Hurt, is desperately trying to save the insurance giant AIG.
It's another bailout. With no legislation, the hill's going to go crazy. The country's going to go crazy.
The plane that we flew in on this morning, leased from AIG. Construction downtown, AIG. Life insurance, 81 million policies with a face value of 1.9 trillion. Billions of dollars in teachers' pensions. It's everywhere you want. Too big to fail. Here it is.
Peter, as you wrote the script, who's the villains? Who are the heroes of that financial crisis?
Well, you know, it's very interesting because I started off with a lot of preconceptions about who the heroes and villains were. But the truth is that one of the ironies of the piece is that there are a lot of heroes and a lot of villains, and sometimes it was the same people. You know, you have people in power like Hank Paulson, who went from being the CEO and chairman of Goldman Sachs and was certainly part of the Wall Street trend working Washington and trying to deregulate, and now here he is in Washington as Secretary of Treasury, trying to deal with a situation that he himself has been part of the creation of. So a lot of it was very surprising. I'd have to say, you know, one of the villains of the piece really is the idea that financial markets are inherently self-regulating and should just be left alone.
You're absolutely right.
So maybe it's Alan Greenspan.
Well, this is
the guy, you know, really, you know, he, not actually one of the big players in the movie, but if the villain is that idea, he's the guy who
somebody who pushed
right?
deregulation, Christia. It's been a few years since this has happened. Could it happen again? What's really changed to prevent what happened in 2008 from happening today?
Oh, it absolutely could happen again. You know, I think, in fact, one of the really scary legacies of 2008 is that the bailout, although it was necessary, has probably made another bailout not less likely but more likely.
Huh.
Because before 2008, we really didn't know, would the U.S. government step in with hundreds of billions of dollars to bail out failing financial institutions? Well, right now, if you're in the markets, you know the answer to that question.
Which means we don't necessarily take less risk but more.